Welcome to Scripture Snippets. Today we're continuing in the Gospel of John, chapter 3, and today's message is titled, Born Again. So let's dig right into verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. And Jesus answered and said to him, Most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? And Jesus answered, Most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but it cannot tell where it comes from and where it goes. So is everyone who is born of the Spirit. And so here we see Nicodemus, a religious leader of his day, respected by the people and expected to know God's ways and the scriptures. And he comes to Jesus covertly at nighttime, secretly under the radar, because probably he would be embarrassed to give Jesus the credibility and come to him during the daytime, because he would fear the rebuke of his fellow Pharisees and actually display a vulnerability, because he is baffled by how much Jesus knows and his miracles that he does. And so he wants to know more things, but he's ashamed of making it obvious that he lacks knowledge and lacks what Jesus has. So he comes to Jesus at nighttime to inquire truth from Jesus. And Jesus responds to him with saying, you must be born again. Why does he say this? Because he's basically saying, unless you are going to have a whole new mindset, a whole new eternal view, and have a new spirit in you, you aren't going to understand anything I'm telling you. Because that's what it means to be born again. You see, when you receive Jesus Christ into your heart, you now go from death to life. Because when we are born from our mother's womb, we are being born into a fallen world destined for death. But when you receive Jesus Christ, he gives you new life. You are now a new creation, and you now walk in the newness of life, and you now have a new destiny of eternal life. And so now he makes all things new. And so that's what it means to be born again. Whether you receive Jesus at 5 years old, or 50 years old, or 100 years old, the day you receive Jesus is the first day of the rest of your eternal life. You're like a newborn baby. And so he's telling Nicodemus that unless you receive me like a newborn baby and receive a new spirit from me, you aren't going to understand and you can't see the kingdom of God. And so the good news is that Nicodemus is going to remember this conversation and take it to heart. Because when Christ is actually crucified and laid to rest, Jesus is going to be cared for by this very man, Nicodemus, along with Joseph of Arimathea. And so here Nicodemus, in plain daylight, is going to put his reputation and even his safety on the line and care for the dead body of Jesus Christ, not even knowing that he will rise again in 3 days. Can you imagine the response of Nicodemus when he met the risen Jesus. Can you imagine him coming to Jesus and worshiping him and saying to him, thank you for the conversation you had with me that emboldened me to trust you and believe in you and truly be born again. So if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you are still dead in your sins. In fact, Jesus once said to someone following him, let the dead bury their own dead. You follow me. If you have not received Jesus Christ, you are spiritually dead. But if you want a new life, an eternal life, to see all things new, to be a new creation, walk in the newness of life, say yes to Jesus today and truly be born again. Happy birthday.